Hobbling, and she's still got her arm in a sling, but she's much, much better. And looking forward to being with us on Wednesday, midweek communion, and then next Sunday at St. Peter's Ovington. So that's just to remind you, please don't turn up here next Sunday. We're all at St. Peter's Ovington. Now, I think it's 10 o'clock, but watch the notices. You think it is, Vicky, 10 o'clock? Good, hopefully 10 o'clock. And welcome to Ian, who isn't doing quite so much this week as he was last week. Thank you so much last week, Ian. But I am doing quite a lot, so please don't start to speak, Ian, until I get to the back.
When the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and princes are home and the shepherds are back with their flock, then the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoner, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among all, to make music in the heart. I will come back to that a little later on. So now we come to our first hymn, Hark the Glad Sound. So please, would you stand?
Let every heart remember the Lord.
prayer or preparation as we pray together. Lord,
direct our thoughts and teach us to pray. Lift up our hearts to worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Be sit on the altar. Christ, the light of the world, has come to dispel the darkness of our hearts. In his light, let us examine ourselves and confess our sins. We pray, Lord, we have sinned against you, have done wrong in your sight. We are sorry and repent. Have mercy on us according to your love. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sin.
Renew our right spirit in us and restore us the joy of your salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive us our sins. Open our eyes to God's truth. Strengthen us to do God's will. And give us the joy of his kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Collect for the third Sunday in Epiphany. Almighty God, whose Son revealed in signs and miracles the wonder of your saving presence, renew your people with your heavenly grace, and in all our weakness, sustain us by your mighty power. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
Please stand. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus, filled with the power of the Spirit, returned to Galilee, and a report about him spread through the surrounding country. He began to teach everyone in the synagogues, and was praised by everyone. When he came to Nazareth, where he was brought up, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom. He stood up to read, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has appointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favour." And then he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendant and sat down. The eyes of all the synagogue were upon him. Then he began to say to them, "Today, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Touch my tongue and my ears, that what we may hear may be your thoughts and your words. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. When I was small, and yes, I was small, before Mr. Griffiths asked, my sisters, as was custom at that sort of time, had budgies, which they kept in a small cage. And we didn't think anything about it, because they were the same sort of cage that lots of other people had, and the birds seemed reasonably content. cage, but those of you who have any experience of keeping birds at home will know that there is a condition called cage bound. And what that is when, it's usually because the birds have never left their cage, is when you open the door to the cage, the birds are afraid to go, either to go out at all, or they go out and take one look and say no thank you, and they go straight back in. That's not unique to birds. I heard a rather interesting tale, I think a couple of weeks ago, of someone who had taken a lot of time and risked a lot of danger to escape from North Korea to the south. And I'm not sure how long they were in the south. I don't think it was very long. I think it was maybe 6 months, a year, something like that. And they decided to go through all the danger again to get back to the north. And apparently that's not the first time that has happened. Because they can't cope with the unfamiliar. They can't cope with the lack of constraint. They are cage bound. And the reason I'm mentioning that is because one of the things that leapt out at me about this passage this morning, there's a lot in it, is the words, "He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives." And actually linked to that, to let the oppressed go free. And we tend to think of all the people who are actually in physical prisons around the world, and not to mention all the tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, who are in prisons for their faith. And we tend to look at that, and that's where we tend to think. But actually there are many other kinds of imprisonment, it seems to me. There was a parrot once. We had a pet parrot, very obese pet parrot. And he died one day, and he said, "Yes, I'm very sad that my parrot is dead, but it is a weight off my shoulders." Sorry about that. And that, I think, is one of the things to consider, a weight off the shoulders. Jesus says, "My yoke is easy and my burden is light." But we burden ourselves with lots of things. And one of the biggest things, I think, probably is guilt. And sometimes the guilt is because it's something that we have done wrong. And sometimes it's just the guilt that we think, oh, we shouldn't be feeling like this. We shouldn't be thinking like this. We shouldn't be doing this. Doesn't matter. It's just as constraining. It's just as imprisoning. And I read that little poem at the beginning about the work of Christmas. To find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to release the prisoners, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among all. And I think we can't do that unless we actually have got rid of any yokes that we've got. Now, I may be talking to people who actually haven't a guilt or a care in the world, in which case that's absolutely brilliant. You have to come and talk to me about it afterwards. But I think that is the thing that we need to bear in mind. Now, any of you who were here, who were unfortunate enough to have to listen to me last week, may remember that I was talking about receiving from God with both hands. And I think receiving forgiveness can be quite hard. And I think particularly if we get our heads round the scale of it. If I can take you back to probably no more than 5 minutes ago, maybe. I'll read the prayer that I think was a bit of a mix-up, which I apologise if I did the wrong thing. But the confessional prayer I've got here, I'd like to read to you. Again. "Lord, we've sinned against you, we've done wrong in your sight. We are sorry and repent." That obviously is a key. Sorry and repent. "Have mercy on us according to your love. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sin. That's what Jesus came to do, to enable our sins to be completely washed away, for us to be completely cleansed, so we are absolutely blameless and innocent. And I don't know, how often do we feel, yes, I'm completely blameless, I am completely innocent. Even if we are, do we actually feel that? It's not self-righteousness, it's not, oh look at me, I'm wonderful. It's a feeling, I think it's probably a feeling of lightness that you could describe it. A weight off the shoulders. When we feel that weight off the shoulders, then I think we can start to go out and do what Jesus wants us to do. With a light heart and light shoulders. We stay seated to sing our next song, Jesus, Be the Center.
Be the reason that I live. Strengthen those who love them. rejoicing in the fellowship of all your saints. We commend ourselves and all Christian people to your unfailing love. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers
for the sake of your Son,
our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. We pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
To our final song, Line of the Lord of Sea and Sky, and the chorus is a little challenging.
Yeah.
Christ our King, pour upon us his abundant gifts and bring us to reign with him in glory. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon us and remain with us always. Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace and the power of the Spirit.
In the name of Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, yes, yes. We went to the art museum. My brother.